Welcome to Biology, My Passion. I am Soumya Harikrishna. Today, we are going to learn about polymerase chain reaction. It is otherwise called PCR. So PCR is a technique used in molecular biology or biotechnology to make multiple copies of our DNA or our gene of interest. Just like how we are taking photocopy of a paper, 100 copies or 1000 copies we can take. The same way, if you have a small piece of gene or DNA, we can make multiple copies of it. That process is called amplification of DNA. Making multiple copies is called amplification of DNA. So PCR is used for amplifying the gene of interest. Gary Mullis was the scientist who invented the technique in 1985. Then requirements of PCR. If you want to do polymerase chain reaction, what are the requirements? First, you need that machine or equipment for doing it. The machine is otherwise called a thermocycler. PCR machine is called a thermocycler. It's a small portable device. Then a DNA template means which DNA we want to amplify. That DNA template is required. Then next is RNA primer. It is just a process of replication, DNA replication. So you know, naturally if DNA replication is happening in our cell, RNA primer is required to initiate the process. Why? Because the enzyme DNA polymerase cannot initiate, it can only add up the deoxyribonucleoside triphosphates. So for the starting, there should be an RNA. So here, since we are doing it artificially, we have to provide RNA primer. They are usually oligonucleotide chains. Oligonucleotide chains mean small sequences artificially synthesized, which are around 13 to 25 nucleotides long. So small stretches. And when we are preparing it artificially, we make them complementary to the 3' end of the DNA that we need to amplify. Okay, then we have to use the enzyme. Of course, replication requires the DNA dependent DNA polymerase enzyme. But here in PCR technique, we increase the temperature about 90 degree. So if you take a normal DNA polymerase enzyme from any normal land animal, we know the enzyme will act only at an optimum temperature. So in our body, the optimum level is 37 degrees Celsius, our body temperature. So if you use that temperature in PCR, that enzyme in PCR, it may get denatured. So to avoid that, we are extracting the enzyme from a bacteria which is present in hot thermal springs. That means very high temperature. That is the name of the enzyme, name of the bacterium is Thermus aquaticus. Okay, so Thermus aquaticus seen in the hot spring. So the average temperature is 100 degrees Celsius. So the enzyme can withstand high temperature and can remain active. So T from Thermus, AQ from aquatica. So we are naming the enzyme as TAC polymerase. This is polymerase enzyme, right? DNA polymerase. Now, for making the new strand, what do we need? We need nucleotides to add to that, right? So deoxyribonucleoside triphosphate, like DGTP, DATP, DCTP and DTTP should be given to the system. Along with that, we need magnesium ions. Because magnesium ions are the cofactor for the proper functioning of this polymerase enzyme. So if you have all these prerequisites or requirements, we can start the process of polymerase chain reaction. Polymerase chain reaction involves three steps. The first one is denaturation, second annealing, third extension. So in the first step, suppose this is the DNA that we need to amplify. The DNA to be amplified. So 3 prime, 5 prime, 5 prime, 3 prime. Okay, so then I'm just drawing it for the sake of understanding it easily into without coiling like this. Okay, so suppose this is the first strand, 3 prime to 5 prime, 5 prime to 3 prime. Okay, so during polymerase chain reaction, during denaturation step, first initially the temperature will go up to 94 degrees Celsius. That means the DNA to be amplified is heated up to 94 degrees Celsius. At this high temperature, what happens? The hydrogen bond will break between the nitrogen bases. So these two strands will separate out. This is called denaturation. So at the end of this process, we get 3 5 prime to 5 prime, one strand. And now another separated strand, 5 prime to 3 prime. So these two strands are now open. So they can act as a template for the formation of the next new strands. Okay, we know DNA replication is semi-conservative. One template strand on which the new strand will be forming. Now next step is annealing. Annealing means what? Joining. The word meaning of annealing is joining or sticking. So this time we are bringing the temperature to 40 degree to 60 degree in between. We are cooling it down. So during that time, suppose this is the 3 prime to 5 prime end and this is the next one 5 prime to 3 prime. We know that by default, it's a thumb rule when you are studying molecular genetics that new strand will be forming in 5 prime to 3 prime direction. The new strand polarity I am telling, 5 prime to 3 prime, always remember whether it is replication or transcription, you have to remember the new strand polarity is 5 prime to 3 prime. So what should be the polarity of the template strand? It should be 3 prime to 5 prime because at the 3 dash end only a 5 prime can be attached. So here what happens, the RNA primer that we gave, it is complementary to this some stretches here. It is oligonucleotide, I told you, very short stretches. So based on complementarity rule, the RNA primer will attach here because it can initiate the process. Okay, so the second step is annealing or joining. Here what is joining? The RNA primer is joining with the template strand at the 3 dash end. So this is the 5 prime end of the RNA strand. So here is the 5 prime, here is the 3 prime. So the next step is extension. During this step, we are increasing the temperature to 72 degrees Celsius. Extension means what? It is extending or elongating. So in this step, I am drawing here. In this step, the new DNA strand will be formed using deoxyribonucleotide triphosphates, NTPs, with the help of TAC polymerase enzyme and magnesium ion. So it will be added one by one based on the complementarity. Suppose here it is 8, T will be added. Here it is G, C will be added. If it is C, G will be added. Like that, it will extend. So at the end of the third step, from one single DNA that we had, now we have two new DNA strands. One is here, one is here. Now what happens? The machine will automatically switch to the denaturation step. No lag, it will go back to denaturation. Then again, these two will get separate. So four template strands will form. Four new DNA strands will form by annealing and extension. Again repeat, it is a cyclic reaction. Okay, so what happens? Ultimately, every time it is becoming increasing and finally we will get billions of copies of the DNA to be amplified within a short period of time. So this technique is very well used in molecular biology, biotechnology, especially in the field of forensic science, where we may get a very small sample of DNA, we have to amplify it. Or in the fossil studies, we may get a DNA that we can amplify. Or we can do it in the molecular diagnosis of diseases like AIDS, where HIV detection in ELISA, we can use PCR in the initial stages.